Hey guys, it's Nick. Nick writes here on YouTube. It is Wednesday, June 29th, 2011. If you noticed, I've kind of been super happy, peppy, funny in some of my video logs, but today I'm going to kind of go on more of a serious note. At work, we sponsor a fundraiser known as Falling Whistles. For those of you who don't know what Falling Whistles is, I'm just going to talk a little bit about it. I apologize if I cry because it's very heartbreaking, and just an emotional topic to talk about. But it all started with Sean Carrasso, who went to the Democratic Republic of Congo with Tom Shoes to go help put shoes on kids' feet who were walking around on their bare feet when. When he found out about children being used to fight rebel armies that were attacking the Congo. None of the boys are over the age of 15. So I'm just going to read a little bit from the website, from the story listed on the website, and I'll post the link as well where you can find out more information and see how you can go to help. So the older children who were able to hold guns, they're abducted, plucked from their homes, they're tied up, they're beaten, and then they're trained how to kill. I know that there were a few boys that were forced to live in a hole 20 hours a day where they would have to live in their own excrement. And when they were, the 4 hours a day that they were let out of the hole, they were trained how to shoot a gun, and they were beaten, and they were tortured. However, the boys that were not big enough to hold a gun were given merely a whistle and put on the front lines of the battle. Those little boys, their sole duty was to make enough noise to scare the enemy and then to receive with their bodies the first round of bullets. Lines of boys follows nothing more as a temporary barricade. Those who tried to flee were shot at from behind. The soldiers called it encouragement to be brave. Without a gun to protect themselves, the smallest boys were placed between the crossfire of two armies, forces fighting for reasons far beyond their ability to understand. With Falling Whistles, their only choice is to feign death or face it. Falling Whistles, on the website, for anywhere from, I believe, $43 to $103, you can purchase whistles, just like the ones the little boys are given to try to scare off the rebel armies. All proceeds go 100% to the rehabilitation and the rehabilitation of these people, and just to do what we can for the other war-affected people in the Congo. So how you can help is you can go to www.fallingwhistles.com, check out the story, find out exactly what Falling Whistles is, aside from what I've told you, and you can purchase a whistle of your own. They have whistles from brushed silver to whistles made of gunmetal from bullets, to solid gold whistles. It's a 100% nonprofit organization, and I highly recommend that you help do what you can, because little boys who can't even hold a gun shouldn't be set at the front lines of a war when they can't even understand it. And even if they could, it's outrageous, and it's heartbreaking to think that people think that it's okay to do something like that. So, shorter video today, somewhat depressing, but I just wanted to explain how I feel and something that I feel is beginning to be very close to my heart. I wear this whistle on a daily basis as a reminder of how lucky I am, and to remind me to think of those less fortunate. So I hope that you'll do the same, and I hope that you'll join me in being a whistleblower for peace. Thanks, guys.